Oh, hey, thanks for coming in today, everybody. It's been about a week since I was able to stream last. I've been working. But I'm here. And we're going to fly the Phenom tonight. Welcome to it. Okay. Thanks for coming in today, everybody. We are flying the Phenomenal Phenom. It's been a while since I've flown this thing, or X-Plane in general, so we'll see how I do tonight. I got everything updated on her and everything, so we should be all good. Yeah, we gotta get started up. But the first thing I'm gonna do before we even get moving on anything else here is I'm gonna talk to my buddy Austin. One of my Vatsim buddies that I've met in person before. He's on Minneapolis Center. He's gonna get us our clearance out of this random airport that we've chosen tonight, which is called Eagle River Union. So here's the flight plan tonight. We're going to take off out of this Eagle River Union Airport, which is Echo Gulf Victor. And we are going to fly this IFR route that I've come up with on my own to Lincoln, Nebraska. That's the plan for tonight. And this is helping out a Minneapolis ARTCC event, Tracon Tuesdays. They got Omaha and Lincoln up tonight, so we're going to give them a little bit of traffic there. So here's this Eagle River Union, just a little uncontrolled field, so we're going to have to get a IFR hold for release kind of clearance. Plenty of runway for us, 5,000 feet here for the Phenom. Shouldn't be any issues getting out of here and then going into Lincoln, Nebraska. So that's the plan for this evening. So let's go ahead and get this airplane going in the direction of getting started. So I've already got the batteries on. We'll turn these to auto. Turn the bleeds to auto. We'll turn this to auto. We'll worry about the tests later. Over here, we want the hydraulic pumps to be open. The ELT is armed. The belts are on. That's all good. So these are auto, good. We don't need anything over here. That's good. We need this to be ECS both. Cabin fan, all that is good. The engine ignition is going to be auto. And all that should then be set. What am I got? ELT not armed. ELT light not armed. Emergency light not armed. Oh, whoops. That's what I'm looking up, right up here. Armed. Okay, let's go ahead and throw some lights on. I'll start with taxi light. Make sure these are up right, and that's all good. Alright. Okay, so I think the only other thing we need to do, I gotta push this guy in. And now we just gotta start it. So we'll clear left. And start our left engine here. So we got our left engine started, and then we'll start the right engine. I need to adjust some volumes here real quick. Let's see, open volume mixer. That was an accident. So now I gotta bring this down. Alright, now I gotta adjust all that again. That messed up. Okay, now that I've fixed my mistakes there, let's go back inside. Alright, so everything's moving on in here. So now the next thing we're going to do is get a clearance from our good buddy Austin. Minneapolis Center, good evening. Phenom 124, Mike Charlie on the ground at Eagle River Union requesting IFR clearance to Lincoln.
River 124, Mike Charlie, Minneapolis Center, cleared from the Eagle River Airport to the Lincoln Airport. Now stop. Climb and maintain 5,000. Squawk 4225. Clearance void if not off by 2315. It's not off by 2315. Advise Minneapolis Center not later than 2320 of intentions. Contact Minneapolis Center 133.4 on departure.
Alright, we are cleared as filed, 5,000 initial, 4225 squawk, and we're void if not off by 2315. We'll advise of intentional landing at 2320 and departure 133.4. Phenom 124, Mike Charlie.
Phenom 24, Mike Charlie, route back correct. No traffic observed in the vicinity of Eagle River. Frequency change approved.
Call you in a bit. So frequency change approved, we're talking Unicom, we're taxiing out, taking off here. He gave us an uptime of 15, that's 12 minutes, we should be ready to go by 12 minutes from now, chat. I'm pretty comfortable with that. So let's go ahead, we got our 5,000 feet set. We're gonna start with a vertical speed of 2,000 feet per minute on the initial climb out here, and probably a cleared as filed, so it'll be direct to our first fix. So let's go ahead and get a flight plan loaded up in here. I need to go ahead and delete this one.
That's our craft, Minneapolis Information Bravo now current.
We need a new flight plan, there we go. So we're gonna take off out of EGV here, and we're gonna go Euclair.
Southwest 4479, radar contact sailed, altitude leaving.
Then Rochester, which is Romeo Sierra Tango. And then Omaha VOR, which is OVR. And then direct to our destination, which is KLNK. That's our flight plan right there. Bing, bang, boom, it's as easy as that. And then because we'll just take off and go direct, what we'll do here is we'll go up here and we'll just do direct and activate.
24, fly heading 300, vectors for the visual runway 12.
And that'll get us going directly to there on the departure. So all that's all set and ready to go. Flight plan's in. We got initial altitude 5,000. I gotta get the squawk code of 4225. That's in there. All right. So we're looking sharp so far. All right. The altimeter here, let's check. I'm going to cheat with just Active Sky. Looks like 3000, so 3000 is set. We can go ahead and remove the GPU, close the panel. And the next thing is going to be looking at our V speeds here. So what do we got? We got a weight of 6,931. So come over here to our departure chart. We'll use 7200 speeds. The temperature is 25. So 25 we'll use again. We'll use 7200 speeds just to round up.
Sorry, did you give 103, 103,
114. So 103, 103, 114.
I did, but I can't
now
just to maintain 8,000.
103.
Well, does that maintain 8,000?
103 and 114. And then our VFS is going to be 128. We'll worry about the landing speeds when we get closer to destination. So our speeds are set. That's all fine and dandy. Set our 128 right here for our VFS speed. Alright, so that's all set up and ready to go.
Okay, 4211, leave my airspace. Chicago Center's offline. Frequency change approved.
Let's go ahead and put that back there. This is 3000. Let's reset this. All right. I can't think of anything else that we need to do to get this bird set up. Jay Smitty, thanks for coming in today. We got everything set up on our plane. We've got our clearance. We're going to go ahead and let's see. I think we're all set, chat. I think we're all set, ready to go. So let's go ahead and remove the parking brake and start our taxi. So I do need to, I gotta do the test.
1624 to center maintain 4,000.
Okay.
Down to 4,
that's 1624. That's all she wanted for me. So we're good. So let's go ahead. We gotta switch to Unicom. And we'll talk to this guy, our buddy Austin here on departure once we're airborne. So let's go ahead. Eagle River Union traffic. Phenom 124 Mike Charlie is going to be taxiing out for a south westbound departure, Eagle Union traffic. Let's see, the wind is 240 at 7. We'll use runway 22. Let's zoom in and find out how do we get to runway 22 here. Looks like we're kind of, you know what? We're going the wrong way here, chat. We should be going the other way out of the ramp. Kind of locked myself in here. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna back taxi the runway, right? Which way am I looking? 22. Wait a second. Yeah, we're gonna back taxi on the runway. I messed up here a little bit, chat. We're gonna have to go and back taxi on runway 22 here since I've made mistakes. Eagle River traffic, Phenom 124 Mike Charlie is back taxiing on runway 22, Eagle River. So we're clear to the right. Go ahead and do a little back taxi. Let's get our flaps set for 1 degree for the takeoff. Alrighty. We're looking good for right meow. I feel like the sound is not... Let's go ahead and get the sounds up. A little better, I think. We still got 5 more minutes on our clearance void time, so we're good. We'll loop around here on runway 22, and we will depart out of here. I almost did that perfectly, chat. Look at that. Right down the pike. Eagle River Union traffic. Phenom 124 Mike Charlie is departing runway 22. Eagle River Union. 4 gathers. Thank you for the follow, by the way. I appreciate it. For some reason, did that not pop up? I don't know why that didn't pop up. 4 gathers. Thank you for the follow. It was 2 minutes ago. My stream labels. I don't know why that didn't work. Try to reset stream labels here real quick. Stream labels. Alright. It's loaded up. So hopefully we'll be good to go now. Thank you for the follow. I appreciate it. Alright. That's all set. We're all set. Let's go ahead and do it to it, chat. And we were cleared on course, so we'll just hit nav as soon as we get in the air. Takeoff thrust is set. V1 rotate. V2, positive rate, gears up. And we'll just go ahead and go get the autopilot on. We'll go nav, start tracking our course. Eagle River traffic, Phenom 124 Mike Charlie departing the southwest, last call, Eagle River. And we'll switch over to departure here. Flaps up. Minneapolis Center, Phenom 124 Mike Charlie is off of Eagle River, 3,000 for 5,000 on course.
Over 124 Mike Charlie, Minneapolis Center radar contact. Climb and maintain level 320.
Climb to 320, Phenom 124 Mike Charlie. So we'll go right to flight level change here, and we'll climb at 230. We got climb power set, flight level 320, we're on course. Flight level change, 230 knots is the optimal flight level change for this aircraft. And we should be good to go. Why does it look like I have not enough fuel? Hold on, we might have to cheat for a second here. I apologize. For some reason it wasn't showing me with enough gasolina. So we had to cheat for a second. I had it set before, but something must have happened. Cyclic Commuter, thank you for coming in today. Good evening, have a great flight. Thank you, sir. I appreciate your kindness. But we're up and out of here. She's flying. Our phenomenal Phenom. It's been a while since I've been on X-Plane 11. Of course, we have the Ortho XP for the entire United States. Our nice little 124 Mike Charlie Tail Phenom 300. Climbing right on out of here.
Delta 16, 24,
she can climb at that 230 if she wants to at our climb thrust here.
1-0-0-1620 Corp. Delta 1624 in the air. Wind at Turin Airport going to be about 12 o'clock, 15 miles, report in sight.
Again, this is our good buddy Austin. I know him from in person chat. I met him on VATSIM, but I've also met my good friend Austin here in person before when I lived in Pittsburgh. Neither one of us lives in Pittsburgh anymore. He moved somewhere. I have no idea where, to be honest with you. Long if I said I remember chat, and now I feel bad. But, yeah, good friend of mine. Oh, excuse me, chat. I'm so sorry. So I don't know why this didn't work. I'm going to do something real quick, chat, so excuse
me. Delta 1624, we do not have the field currently, but we'll keep looking until
just
we pick
test.
Up the localizer.
Delta
1624, Roger, maintain present.
So it is working. I don't know why it didn't
work. Alright, we'll maintain present heading.
When four gatherers followed me, but it is working. Kitty Monster, thanks for coming in today. Good to see you, sir. Alright, we're already through 10,000 feet. We're looking good, feeling good. Airplane's doing what it needs to do at our climb power, 230 knots. She climbs like a rocket ship. We love it. And we're on course to Lincoln, Nebraska for the event that Minneapolis ARTCC is putting on this evening. Nice little VFR-oriented event. Omaha and Lincoln are the two featured airports tonight. So we're flying into Lincoln.
Aircraft calling. What was the call, sir?
Out of Eagle River Union, we just took off out of Phenom, which I haven't flown in a little bit, so I'm happy to be flying this thing again. I will say that the
Charlie Romeo
radio is a little loud, so I'm going to fix that by adjusting
Charlie
the volume.
Charlie Romeo 47, information Bravo, requesting IFR from Minneapolis to Montreal, plan file.
Alright.
Charlie, Romeo 47, Clarkson request, standby number 1.
Yeah, so it's just a VAT USA event. Both Lincoln and Omaha featured for Minneapolis ARTCC tonight.
Alright, go to the visual, 1-2 right, Delta 1624.
So me and Microsoft Flight Sim were exclusive these days. It has been quite a while. I will not lie, it has been a while since I have flown on X-Plane 11 here, but I decided to whip out the Phenom tonight for just a quick flight into Lincoln since they got the event going. It's going to be a fairly quick stream because I'm probably only going to do the one leg tonight.
Correction number 1-9-4-9-0 Delta.
Let's go ahead and set our standard Barrow,
2992. Over to
coming
the
18,
Omaha
standard
approach,
right there.
1-9-4-9-0 Delta. Thank you.
Boom.
Charlie Romeo 47 clear to the Charlie Yankee uniform.
Keep
Lima
on climbing
airport.
Out.
Cold 7 departure, Dell's transition minus file. Climb the acidic set, maintain 7,000. Expect level 370, 10 minutes after departure. Departure 133.4, squawk 2626.
Charlie Romeo 47, direction for Montreal, Charlie Yankee uniform Lima.
Oh yeah, that's right, I got wing views set up, I almost forgot. And I got this guy right here that we can look at too.
And like flight plan. Initial climb 7,000 and squawks 2626.
I turned my volume down, that pilot's just really loud,
back,
so.
Track, push and back, push and start is pilot's discretion, call for taxi 17 and the Minneapolis Altum 1398.
Volumes here.
Call you back when ready to taxi, Charlie 47 and push back as discretion.
Lower the volumes a wee bit. Get you guys a nice little wing view as we continue our climb out here.
Wind 17010, runway 12 right, clear to land.
And our Phenom 300. 16 way. Yeah, if you're just joining, welcome to stream. We took off out of Eagle River Union, Yucco Golf Victor. We're flying in Lincoln, Nebraska for this event that's going on tonight, hosted by Minneapolis ARTCC. They are doing one of their TradeCon Tuesdays. Omaha, Lincoln are featured from now until, that's 10 o'clock Eastern time tonight that they're doing this. So that's what we're flying in for in our Phenom. Give them a little bit of traffic. Gives me stream that an X-Plane 11 stream that I haven't done in for a long time. Love this thing. So, good to be back in it. Keep on climbing out for the time being at our 230 knots, which is the correct climb speed. When we get a little bit higher, we'll adjust this to just vertical speed climb. Actually, we might as well just keep that. We'll go ahead and increase our speed here to 50 for the climb on the flight level change. Actually, we're just getting into Mach now, so we'll do Mach. I don't remember what the Mach is for the climb in this plane. I'm trying to remember what the ideal Mach was. What's the ideal Mach in this thing? Climb, then Mach 0.6. It says Mach 0.60, chat. Interesting. So we'll go Mach 0.60. How about that? That's what it says.
Southwest 4479, leaving minor speeds.
So while the sim corrects, it's going to do some weird stuff because the sim does it more rapidly than the real airplane probably would. Lincoln also has a high LS approach. I'll have to take a look and see. I don't really know this airplane a whole lot. Or that airport a whole lot. Let's take a look. Lincoln, Nebraska. High ILS. Oh, okay, let's see what this is. So you're really only supposed to do like a high ILS if you're military, as far as I understand. Yeah, I don't know if our airplane would be capable of doing that, Chad. It might not be in the box there for that, because it's supposed to be military that only does the high ILS stuff, so. It's not going to matter, though, because for this last 1,000 feet, I'm going to reduce the climb to 1,000 feet since we're in RBSM airspace. 31 for 32.
And
we'll just go ahead and bring this up here as fast as she'll go. We'll probably just do whatever we get assigned by ATC since there is ATC online. So if they assign us a visual, we'll do a visual. If they assign us an ILS, we'll do an ILS. If they assign us whatever, we'll do whatever gets assigned for us into Lincoln tonight.
1624, we'll be going to gate Golf 2. 1624, text RFBF Bravo.
Sorry to sound lame, chat, but we're going to do this by the book tonight, which I usually do. I usually fly things the way that they would be done in the real world. So, sorry, Candy Monster. Sorry to disappoint your need for something more.
6011 13011
Oh, I gotta renew your sub, Kenny Monster. I just realized this. Let's get that taken care of. What's the matter, McFly? There you go. There's your resub, Kenny Monster. We can't not give Kenny Monster a resub. He's in so many other Twitch channels. He's got to spread the love of the cinnamon bun wherever he goes. So, that had to be done, chat. It has to be done. It's like a requirement. Can't be escaped. Must be done. Plan on cruising at 0.76 tonight. I'm gonna try and get my speed set to do about 0.76. So we'll see where my throttle needs to be set for that. Since there's no auto throttles on this airplane, I'm getting so comfortable with having auto throttles on the 175, chat. What a beautiful thing having auto throttles is. Oh my god, it's like a dream. So now that I have to fly this without auto throttles, it's gonna be like, I actually have to pay attention to my speed. It's crazy. It's like my dinosaur 145 days. See if we can get this throttle set to hold our Mach 7.6 right about here. Is that going to do it? That looks like it might do it right there.
Minneapolis Center, good evening. Delta 1637, checking in. Flight level 370.
This has been one of the easiest to manage. You're absolutely right. No, this has been one of the better airplanes to manage without auto throttles in the sim, for sure. Yeah, Jay Smitty, Kenny Monster gets around. He knows what he's doing on Twitch. There's a reason why he's admin in this channel. We're not. How are we making you sound pathetic, man? You're a good hombre. You're a good man. Kenny Monster, we appreciate you not only on here, on this channel and on Twitch, but we also appreciate you very much. Appreciate you very much in the Virtual USA Flying Club. By the way, how much fun was that Virtual USA Flying Club 2-year anniversary event last week? And then also, I know Jay Smitty ran an event last night that I unfortunately was not able to attend because I was still on my way home from the commute. But there was a sea lane crossfire event that looked really cool as well. Club's been doing great. Couldn't be happier with the flying club. Eric Flight, thanks for coming in today. Pretty much everyone that's chatting in this channel right now is a flying club member. But couldn't have been happier with that anniversary event and how the club is doing and progressing and all that. So it really is a beautiful thing, and I thank all you guys for your support in that. If you're watching this channel and you have no idea what I'm talking about when I'm talking about the Flying Club, then you probably haven't been watching my channel very much. But if you're a VATSA member and you enjoy general aviation flying, take a look at that Discord link. It's the link to the Virtual USA Flying Club. It's a club that I run a bunch with all these hooligans in here that are talking right now. Eric Flight, Kenny Monster, Jay Smitty, Good Fixins, they're all involved. You do have to be a VATSA member to join, but if you love GA flying, get involved. Join us. Our events are only getting better and better as the years go on. We just started our third year as a club, had our two-year anniversary event last week on Wednesday. Our actual two-year anniversary was celebrated yesterday. So happy birthday to the Virtual USA Flying Club. Looking forward to another great year, more great events. The next Virtual USA Flying Club event hasn't been posted yet, but it's most likely going to be a week from tonight. So Tuesday night next week, I'm probably going to do another one of those Make Mike Sweat events where I go onto one of the towers in New York ARTCC and have the Flying Club members try and make me sweat. It worked last time because last time I was not at my best controlling, so I'll try to do a lot better controlling this time for the Make Mike Sweat event. Most likely going to be a week from tonight. I'm going to close the poll for the voting for which airport tonight. And then I'm going to whip the event together and I'm going to post it because I believe I'm going to be good to go for the event. So last time, yeah, it's going to be a week from tonight, as long as everything goes to plan. So I'll work on that later tonight, like I said. Tonight at 9 o'clock Eastern, so an hour and a half from now, I'm going to close that poll. Whatever airport wins will be the one that gets featured. And I'll take care of all that, posting all that tonight. So we're looking forward to doing that next week, since I'm not going to have any plans. Sarah's going to be working on all three of my days off next week, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, which is a huge, huge bummer, chat, not going to lie. But it does mean I'll probably be doing some flights and stuff on those nights, because pretty much all my other friends are also working on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday next week when I have my 3 days off next week. So that's kind of bummer. But I'll just go spend some time with the Virtue Safe Flying Club and you guys. So that way I don't feel alone, chat. How about that? Help me to feel less alone. It's definitely a lot easier in real life than it is in the sim, in terms of doing a traffic pattern, because of the ability to turn your head and move around and look with the peripheral vision and all that, whereas in the sim you have to have something set to do it, unless you're using VR. That's a whole different ballgame. It's got to be pretty easy for downwind sim using his VR to do all that kind of stuff.
American 601, just verify you're online, not as an observer. I have a no data block on you.
Yeah, I'm not fancy enough to do the VR or even the track IR or any of that stuff. It's just not something that I'm super into, to be honest with you guys, which is why I haven't done it on stream. I don't even own it. Yeah, it is a lot of fun to watch.
Gotcha. Now, contact Chicago Center 120.35.
120.35, Mike.
Nice little turn with the wing view there, you guys. You're welcome for that. We'll go back into the cockpit now. Now we're going from the Eau Claire VOR to the Rochester VOR. Cruising right along here on our way to Lincoln, Nebraska. The VATSIM data servers are down because VATSPY won't update. Let's see if it's fixed yet.
Charlie, Romeo 47, runway 17, taxi via Delta, Sierra.
It's like the data servers are down. Because they're... VATSPY's not working. Yep, nothing. Gotta love it when VATSPY goes blank. No connections, no nothing. Just means that the VATSIM data servers are down, so...
Could you repeat,
Delta, Sierra...
Kitty Monster, yes, Rochester VOR. I'm just flying... This is my route. I'll show you the route. I took off out of a random airport by the name of Eagle River Union. So we took off out of here, we're going there to Eau Claire, we just passed over, then we've got the Rochester VOR, then we're going to have the Omaha VOR, and then into Lincoln, Nebraska. So that's our route that we're doing tonight. I'll zoom out for the whole picture for you. Right there. Boom, 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 boom. That's what we're doing tonight in the Phenom. VATSPY has been flaky. It's probably just the data servers. That's by itself is usually not the issue when it comes to that. We're going to have to fly again next summer. Yes, we will, Eric Flight. Oh, you know what? Since you brought it up, let's go ahead and slap it on the YouTubes and have you guys take a look while we're just cruising along here to some of that flight. Give me 1 second. Let me... I might have to pull... I'm going to have to pull it from... Because it's a... hidden link, right? You didn't put it to the public yet, I don't think, Eric, so let me see if I can go find it real quick. I'm gonna dig a little bit to go find it. There it is! Right now. There's us taking Axie out of Stewart. Unfortunately, Eric wasn't able, I guess the hookup didn't work well enough to have the audio come through, all the ATC and us talking to each other, which is kind of a bummer. So all you kind of see is us flying around, but hey, you can see New York City coming up in the distance right here. So let's get a little bit closer in. There's New York City. Bit of a hazy day out there. It wasn't the clearest of days. A little bit of haze out there in New York City, but not too bad overall. Me some 1080p. What are we doing, computer? There we go. That's more better.
Whiskey 34, we filed 3-9-2. America 2634, Minneapolis Center.
Me in the right flying. Freedom Tower.
America Southwest 632, level 350. America Southwest 632, Minneapolis Center.
Sure, Eric had a blast flying along, getting a view of the skyline, see the Verrazano Bridge out there in the distance as well. So we flew all the way down and then flew all the way back up to the north. You can see me make my turn here. Eric's going to fly for a little bit while I take pictures, but that's a great view right there. Look at the view of the city right there, chap. Oh, yeah. Sorry. Sounded a little weird. Not going to lie, that sounded a little weird. I'm sorry. But yeah, it was a great flight, and yeah, we'll definitely do it again. We don't even have to wait for the summer if you want, man. If you want to come do it in like September, October, maybe when it's a little cooler and we're not sweating our balls off and maybe the sky's a little bit clearer and less hazy, let's do it up, man. I would not oppose to that at all. So, you know, let me know. We'll figure it out, you know. I'll find some days off and we'll make it happen, man. Won't be clear until October 8th. Oh, that's right, because of the, that's right. But, yeah, but, like I said, I'm not opposed to going up when it gets cooler, man. Throw a jacket on, October, November. We can do it again. Usually around that time, if we can find a nice clear day, it'll be a clearer view, less hazy, it'd be great, so. Just let me know, man. I'm glad that your recovery is going well. That's good to hear, man. I'm really, really happy to hear that. So yeah, that's just a little taste of the flight that I did with Eric. I'm not going to go and show the whole thing on the stream here, chat. We're going to focus up on what we're doing here, but I did fly almost the whole flight, and yeah, I was throttle happy. That's how you can tell I'm a jet pilot, is because I was super throttle happy. You're usually not that throttle happy in the GA planes, so that's definitely something that...
Southwest 632 to set a maintain.
Oh, was today the day that Melvin went in for surgery? Shoot. Was it? Hello? I don't remember now. Good call, Katie Monster. I don't remember if today was the day.
Southwest 632 to
Let me ask. He's online on Discord, but he's always online on Discord, so that doesn't necessarily mean anything.
ExoGen 85, just set a maintain level 360.
See if I can find some details. If it is, I hope he's doing well. Like I said, he's online on the Discord. I'll private message him, see what he says. Maybe it is tomorrow. We'll go ahead and see how he's doing, though, just in case. Always a little bit of nerves when you're getting ready for the surgery. I know I was very nervous when I went in for my shoulder surgery, chat. I've got a very awkward picture of me in my recovery that I guess I can pull up on the stream. Why not? This is a post-surgery picture, like the taken literally like a couple hours after the surgery when I'm still loopy on the drugs, so bear with me on how silly I'm going to look. But, there you go. Yeah, so this was me after my surgery. You can see, just look how loopy I look. Oh my goodness. Just like, you can tell, like. But yeah, me in the sling and everything after I had my labrum surgery. This was way back in December 18th of 2019, so that was a while ago. And thankfully, the shoulder is all good now. But I do know that Brant's got his work cut out for him, and we're hoping for the best for him, of course, after he gets the rotator cuff surgery there. He'll be more like me. He's becoming more like me every day, including now shoulder surgery. Someday he's going to be some kind of pilot,
Kansas
chat.
Kansas City Airport or CQ departure for Dodge transition of a foul. Climb the acidic that maintains 7,000. Departure with me, squawk 6343.
6-6-8-2, Kansas City, departure for Dodge transition. Climb the 7,000 climb and
the 157 read back correct, push and start pilot discretion, call for taxi 12 right for departure.
Oh, do you guys want to see the picture of Delilah that in This was the picture of Delilah that I've ended up becoming the emoji. This is the one that my buddy Dylan used to make the Delilah emote. This was the picture right here. You can tell, look at the face, look at her eyes. And her little collar, her little heart collar. That's where he got the idea for the heart, was the little collar right there and the face right there. So that was the picture, chat, that was used for the emote.
America 2634 to 7 18 16000.
Let's see, what else can I show you guys? Might as well just go ahead and do this right here. We got I was in Monterey, California on Sunday. Was my overnight. Was pretty sweet overnight. Look at that little fog bank right over there coming in. It was moving in as we were out there, but right along the beach, Del Monte Beach right there.
Charlie Romeo, Romeo 47.
Very nice. This was some smoke in the mountains over Montana. We were flying from Calgary back to Dallas, and just all the wildfires. You can see all the smoke all in the mountains and everything. Pretty wild. And then a nice little sunset in DFW here. It's a little 175 action right there. Yeah. So there you go. Oh, there's me and Sarah. Went to the Red Bull game. We're going to the Red Bull game tomorrow night, actually, chat. As long as it doesn't rain, though. Like, thunderstorms. There's a chance of thunderstorms, so. Almost forgot to do the Prime resub. It doesn't show that you resubbed. Interesting. Pilot Blinks, hello. Thank you for coming in today. Good to see you. Welcome to the channel. So I'm still... Yes, I'm still with her, Kenny Monster. We're 3 months strong now in our relationship. Wait, May, June, July, August. Yeah, 3 months strong now in our relationship together, Kenny Monster. And we're definitely still together. And like I said, we're going to go to the Red Bull game tomorrow night as long as the thunderstorms don't screw that up. There is that Prime resub. Eric Flight, thank you for the 10-month resub. I appreciate you.
Eric Flight just subscribed. Thanks for coming in today.
There it
another
is.
Month.
Another month. Pilot Binks, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you, sir. Could you help decide either SSG 747 or Magnite 787? The answer is no, I cannot, and the reason is because I've not flown either one, Pilot Binks. And because I have not ever flown either one of those, I'm not going to be able to help you out. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. But I'm not going to just randomly pick one either. It looks like someone in the chat has. Good Fixins is saying the SSG. See, he's a good friend of mine, so I would trust him. So you might want to consider the SSG then. Kenny Monster is saying the same thing as well. So it looks like, according to my good friends here in the chat, that the SSG 747 might be the way to go versus the Magnite. But again, I haven't flown neither, so I'm not going to be personally able to help you out with that one. Alright, so we just passed over the Rochester VOR. We're going now to the Omaha VOR, and that's going to get us close also as well to our destination of Lincoln, Nebraska. See, according to this, we're about halfway there, according to our little flight tracker thing in the back. There you go, Pilot Binks. A lot of decent information from our fellow chatters tonight. Hopefully that helps your decision. Oh yeah, look at this beauty right here. 175 action, chat. Look at that. Oh, holy baby. She's my new plane, and she's a beauty. She's definitely better than the 145, chat. I'm not going to sit here and try and say otherwise. The 145 was a great airplane. Won't lie about that either. I enjoyed flying the 145, but the 175 is better. Just be honest. I'm enjoying the hell out of it.
85,
say indicated airspeed. Indicating Mach 4. That's why it's 30 higher. Something like that, right? That's how that works.
73 or 6, 75, 85.
That's why the Cessna 152 is better than the C-130, right? Because C-152 is higher than C-130, right? Right?
Sorry, calling, I missed that.
Yeah, see this plane just released? Let me open this thing.
We're about
AirTran.
32 miles from the lake.
That's a neat little thing. FedEx
2059, sorry about that. Minneapolis Center climb and maintain.
You know what? Let's look at some speeds real quick here, chat. For our landing, so that I don't forget. Right now, it looks like we're gonna be at a total mass. We're at 67.18. So we'll just round down 66, 67 for the landing weight. So if we go 67, let's come over here. Oh, I gotta scroll back up. Let's go. Unfactored approach, there we go. Alright, so let's go ahead. We'll do, it's a pretty decent runway, I think. How long is the runway over here at Lincoln? Yeah, they're all decently length runways. So what we'll do is we'll do approach 1 flaps 3 for the landing. Wing engine ice off, wing stab off, okay. We'll plan on it'll probably be 6600 by the time we get there in terms of burning off some gas. So 12, 109, 123. So let's go V speeds. Our VAC is 112. That's our approach speed. Our ref speed is 109. And our VFS is 123.
Southwest 632, contact Omaha.
So those speeds are set. So now we got our landing speed set, and that'll be ready to go so we don't forget later. What altitude did you guys fly the Skyline route? We did some of it at 1,500 feet, and we did some of it at 2,000 feet. We actually had some altitude changes along the way while we were in the actual Skyline. So we were at either 1,500 feet or 2,000 feet. It did vary a little bit depending on what ATC wanted us to do along the Skyline. So.
Air Canada 58, ready for taxi.
Air Canada 858, runway 12 right, taxi,
Yeah, it was a pretty decent amount of comm work. They were quite chatty when we went over the Skyline, for sure. Busy day in New York. As it usually is,
Taxi via Alpha, and we're crossing, is that 26? 22.
A little bit of cloud activity going on over here.
Southwest 345, Minneapolis, where
are
you headed?
Someone's off course, chat. Where are you headed, sir? Never a good thing to be told by the ATC. Where are you going?
Yeah, I know that, but when are you off the arrival?
Yeah, it is a good thing to have two of us in there for the Skyline route, Jason. Absolutely right.
All right,
34,
Southwest 345.
I will agree to that. I think we've got about 25, 30 minutes left in this flight, chat. So nothing too long tonight. It's always going to be a fairly quick stream. Just wanted to get into the phenomenal phenom here and do a quick flight for the event tonight over at Omaha and Lincoln.
Okay.
It does look like they've got Omaha fully staffed. Lincoln, I guess, is just going to be covered by the approach because they don't have anyone on the Lincoln Tower there, but that's all right. There's only a handful of us arriving into Lincoln, so we'll be very happy to give them some of that traffic.
Southwest 345, clear direct Maori, Mike Alpha Romeo Whiskey India.
Clear direct Maori, Southwest 345.
See what the weather's doing in Lincoln. Let's see if we can get an idea of maybe what approach we're going to get. I think it's like severe clear out there. Yep, 10 and clear, so we're going to get a visual approach. The wind is 180/10, so we're going to land south. And the runways are 1, there's a 17, 18, and 14. 171814. So, yeah. I'm imagining they're probably going to use runway 18 for us there at Lincoln. So we'll plan on runway 18, plenty of runway. Even if they give us 17, still plenty of runway with the 5,800 feet, so I'm not worried either way. But we'll plan on landing south. In terms of the approaches that they have, for runway 18, there's an ILS. 17 has an RNAV, but we'll probably get the visual backed up by the ILS 18 into Lincoln. So I'm going to go ahead and set the frequencies for that. We got 111.1. Final approach course 177, and because of visual backup of the ILS, we don't really need to worry about all anything else here, because we're just using it to back up the visual. So 111.1.
And near candidate 58,
and
just waiting for some traffic.
What we'll do is we'll go into roll mode here real quick, and we'll set our course of 177. And then we'll put this back to here, and then we'll go back to nav. And that's how we got ourselves set up. And because it's just a visual back to the US, pretty much briefed. Not much else that you need to describe for that.
Delta 1637 to set up pilot's discretion, maintain level 240.
Roger, pilot's discretion down to 240, Delta 1637.
When the COVID thing dies down a little bit, we should do a fly-in for real with virtually safe pilots and help those that can fly with us as well that don't fly for real life. That's not a bad idea. I've been thinking about something like that because we do have, like, the... And for when I'm in New York ARTCC, we've done live events in the past for that. So the thought really has crossed my mind about potentially doing some kind of, you know, virtually safe flying club meetup. But it would take... 7,000, so significant amount of planning to do that, first of all, because we'd have to find a location and a spot to kind of do that. And then the big problem is that I only know my schedule month to month, so the only way that I could do it is on a vacation. But that would mean I would have to then sacrifice a vacation, and now having, you know, being with Sarah and stuff like that, it's tricky. Let's put it that way. It would be something that would be really tricky for me to do. It's something that I definitely would love to do, Eric Flight. You know, that's something that I would absolutely love to do. But I just don't know logistically how I'd be able to pull it off at all. So, but it's... let's just say it's... We'll leave it on the dream list for now. It would be a dream to do something like that, but it's not in the practicality list just yet.
So the 157 runway 12 right taxi via Alpha Cross Runway 4.
Via Alpha Crossing 4, 4-1.
Air Canada 182, are you just south of Traverse City, southwest?
We're just taking off from Thunder Bay.
See if VATSPY is working yet. Yeah, VATSPY is working now. Alright, okay, so here we are. You can see we're getting close. Definitely
Air
more
Canada
than halfway.
6355.
Moving along here at 320. Probably start to get some descent instructions here fairly soon, I would bet. What's the shortest runway you can land the E-175 on? That's a good question. Probably... Well, we fly it into Key West. What's the runway length at Key West? I think that's the shortest runway that we fly it into.
American 424, Minneapolis Center.
Key West is... 5,076 feet. Yeah, so we can get into a 5,000-foot strip pretty easily. I don't think we'd do any lower than that. But, my company doesn't fly into anything smaller than Key West. That I know of, personally.
Warbach, Oscar, Bravo, Hotel.
Usually on a dry runway, every time we do our landing distance calculations, it's usually less than 5,000 feet of runway needed for dry runways. But it always varies depending on weight and other factors too. But yeah, that's why we're able to do Key West. Ask the boss about a jet and come give me a ride.
Yeah,
If only things were that easy, man. It's not like the cowboy days back in like the 30s and 40s from all those books that I was reading. You know, it's not that easy. I wish it was, but...
American 2634, contact Omaha approach 120.1. Exojet 85, contact Omaha approach
1201 is probably going to be our next frequency.
Southwest 345, descend to maintain 16,000.
Probably get a descent here fairly soon.
Maintain 16,000, Southwest 245.
Not yet, but soon. Speaking of books, by the way, that I was reading, Nate has claimed the Fate is the Hunter and the Bob Hoover book. But if anybody in the chat that's a Virtue Safe Flight, you do have to be a Virtue Safe Flying Club member, because that's the only way I'm going to be able to hold of you. But any Flying Club members, if either of you or any of you Flying Club members want a book for free, I've got this Top Gun book by Dan Pedersen, really good, and then Jaeger's autobiography as well. If you want either one of these books, just private message me on Discord, please. I will gladly ship it to you as long as you donate at least $5 to the channel. Because I need to get those books off my hands. I got no space to put them in my room. So, let me know. Both really good books. And like I said, I'd be fine if you just donate like 500 bits or $5 or whatever to the channel. And that'll cover the cost of the shipping. Call that covering the cost of shipping for those books if you want.
Canada 58 holding short runway.
So let me know.
West.
Again, that goes for the Flying Club guys that can message me in the Discord.
Air Canada 858. You're supposed to go to 12 right via Alpha. Okay. Let's see here. Can't wait.
Under.
Yeah, all the books are great. All those books that I've read. I read the Bob Hoover Forever Flying book, Fate is the Hunter, the Ernest Gann book. Of course, Top Gun by Dan Pedersen. He's one of the guys that formed Top Gun. And then Jaeger. They're all great books. All of them. Can start finding some more aviation books to read.
This is what we'll do here. Cross runway 12 left on Charlie, make the left on Charlie 9, join Romeo to Romeo 8. Join Romeo to Romeo 10 for 12 left. We'll go to the bus side.
Cross 12 left, go Romeo 10 for Air Canada 858, and we'll get back to you.
Air Wisconsin 3738, radar contact lost.
I wonder how far, what's the distance between over Omaha to Lincoln? It looks like it's 50 miles, okay.
American 424.
50 miles, alright. Gotcha.
Stop your climb at the flight level.
Cool.
American 424, stop your climb, maintain flight level 360 for now, just for traffic.
Stop climb at 360 for traffic, American 424.
United 262 Minneapolis, that are Climb and maintain flight level.
Nice little cabin we got going on in here.
310.
Fancy pants stuff.
310, 39.
If I remember correctly, the lab, even all this even works.
I'm in the upper set, Delta 157, 2500.
Yep, water in the sink. Nope, don't close. I want to open this thing. That's their sneak peek in their Falcon 8X that they're
working
on.
The 157 Minneapolis Center radar contact. Climb and maintain level 3.
Can even use the lav. Flush it.
320 direct forward dodge.
Kind of gross. Yeah. Close the windows. Look at that. Yeah. So nicely detailed jet here by Aerobasque. Of course, Aerobasque, the ones that do the Phenom 300 on X-Plane 11. Excellent stuff. I've enjoyed flying this thing many times already. And I will keep enjoying flying it, just like I am tonight. Not as pretty as Microsoft Flight Sim 2020 in terms of the landscape. I do have Ortho for XP, but let's be honest, Chad, it does not compare to Flight Sim 2020 when it comes to the scenery. But these X-Plane 11. 16,000 feet on 4 Mike Charlie. 16,000 set chat. We'll go vertical speed. And we'll go. Let's do 2,000 feet a minute. Get this power back.
R124 Mike Charlie for traffic. Turn 10 degrees to the left.
10 left for my Charlie. Alright, so 10 left is 211. We'll round it to 210, heading for traffic. Oh, overcompensate a little bit there, airplane. There you go.
CR, Charlie Romeo, Romeo 47, contact Chicago Center 120.35.
Maznak 42, thank you for coming in today, buddy. Good to see you. Just talking about how you claim two of the four books that I'm trying to give away to make space in the to make space in my room here. I intend to get those shipped out to you tomorrow. I'm going to stop at the post office and try and get those sent on their way.
Delta 157, I have a duplicate code, Squawk 6305.
Yeah, they're both great books, so.
FedEx 2059, leaving my airspace, Denver Center offline, radar 6.
So, I personally like the Bob Hoover book a little bit better because it was just Bob Hoover telling the story. The Fate is the Hunter, it was more of like a storytelling story. It was still very entertaining, don't get me wrong. But that I liked the more factual, and I'm not saying that Fate is the Hunter is a factual too, but it just seemed a little bit more artsy way of telling the story. I preferred the more straight, you know, biography Bob Hoover book was more my taste, but that's just me. But it was still, I enjoyed both of them very much. They're definitely good ways to help kill a commute.
Number 231, standby. Number 124, Mike Charlie, clear. Direct to Lincoln.
Direct destination for Mike Charlie. So we'll go direct to Lincoln. We'll hit nav, destination. Thank you for that $10 tip. So that's Meznak basically paying for the shipping on the two books right there, chat. That was the agreement. So thank you for that. I appreciate you.
Roger. Delta 1637, descend via the Tor D3 arrival, runway 12 right transition to Minneapolis, altimeter 208.
Much appreciated, my good man. Like I said, get those books sent to you hopefully tomorrow. They'll be on their way.
Right transition, Delta 1637. Air Canada 858, cross runway 22, join Romeo. Taxi 212 right via Romeo 10.
Air Canada 58, apologize, just having some issues here with our auto brakes. Not quite sure what's going on. We'll get back to you in a second.
That was 12 left via Romeo 10. Air 124, Mike Charlie, contact Omaha, approach 120.1. Nice talking to you, Mike.
1201, you have a good night, Austin. I don't think there's an ATIS for Lincoln. Nope, there is not. Omaha approach, good evening. Phenom 124, Mike Charlie is flight level 243 for 1616,000.
November 124, Mike Charlie, Omaha approach, good evening. Foxtrot, current expected visual 14. Correction, you're going to Lincoln. I don't think I have a Lincoln ATIS up. And you can expect a visual approach on 18.
Visual for 18, Phenom 124, Mike Charlie. It's kind of what we expected there, chat. I'm going to increase my descent rate here a little bit. So visual backed up by the ILS, 18, that's all set. We briefed it.
070, exocet, that's fine. American 2634, contact Omaha Tower, 132.1, good night.
Over to our community, American 2634.
See, the Lincoln altimeter is 2986, so we'll set 2986 up here, so I don't forget, 2986, and then when we come through 180, I'll set 2986 on there. Yeah, commuting's not fun, especially when it's an hour and a half drive to LaGuardia from where I am, and then a four-hour flight to Dallas. It's rough. It's rough, Chad. I'm not going to sit here and lie. Not my favorite thing in the world, but it's still earning me a paycheck, so.
Exit at 85, turn right heading 110.
110, exit at that time.
Southwest 345, turn right heading 360, vector to final.
Heading 360, vector to final, Southwest 345.
Exocet 85, traffic to follow 12 to 1 o'clock and about 6 miles and 737.
Reduce my descent rate here as we get a little bit closer to the altitude.
Okay, we're okay. Exocet, that's fine.
1,500 feet a minute for the rest of the way.
85, the airport is also 12 to 1 o'clock and about 1 mile.
That way, got the airport in front.
Exit 85, third visual approach, runway 14.
Yeah, I'm glad to be working again, too. And, happy to be on the 175. I guess that's my consolation prize for, having a commute. I got to be on the new shiny jet. 2986, chat. Altimeter set. Let's go ahead. Descent checklist. We got to turn the windshield heats on in this thing for that. Oh, I left the belts on the whole time for the passengers. That's fine. That's fine. They're gonna get up and do what they want anyway, whether the sign is on or off. Let's be honest. So. Not a whole heck of a lot going on out the window here, champ, for the terrain. Of course, we got the Ortho for XP all cooked up for this area, as I do for the entire U.S. on X-Plane 11. Certainly not as pretty as flights in 2020.
November 790060. Cool. Stand by, let me get you a swap code. November 124, Mike Charlie, descend to pilot's discretion, maintain 10,000.
PD down to 10,000, Phenom 124, Mike Charlie. We'll just keep on going down to 10,000 in your chat.
November 790060, squawk 4243.
4243.
Southwest 345, turn left heading 320.
320, Southwest
345. Looks like we go overhead, we're coming close to, there's Omaha, the other airport that's featured in tonight's event. So you can see there's a decent amount of traffic over there at Kilo Oscar Mike Alpha. We're going to fly over the top and make our way towards Lincoln here. And we're going to slow our descent rate even more for this descent down to 10,000 feet. 2,000 feet a minute the rest of the way for that. Actually, no. We're going to keep our descent rate where we had it, because we're only about 9 minutes out. That'll be fine.
Number 7, Niner, 0-6-0-3-0-7.
There's Omaha. Be lying if I knew what river that was that we're coming up. It looks like the Platte River. Platte River coming up on off our nose here, chat. Right along here. Should probably, you know what? We're doing the vision backup by the LS. Let me throw the procedure in here. We're going to do ILS 18. Do vectors off and we'll load it and then we'll activate it when we get the vectors final, because of course we're just doing the visual, but it's good to have everything backed up even when you're doing a visual approach by an instrument approach if there is one. Whoa.
Climb and maintain 3000, maintain VFR, and turn right heading 360 vectors practice. I'm sorry, what kind of approach were you looking for?
Yeah, we're looking to try to do the ILS for one of the 14s or 1A. Turn left to 360 up to 3000 right now.
Separation.
Number 7,
booty, booty, booty.
You can expect practice approach ILS 14 right.
I feel bad for the controllers. I feel slimming that all day.
Southwest 345, turn left heading 240.
240, Southwest 345. Southwest 345, continue left, turn heading 170. 170, Southwest 345.
So we're coming close now. We are about 6 minutes out, probably 10 minutes before we're actually wheels down on the ground in Lincoln. Almost at the end of our journey here tonight. 11 for 10. Direct the field. He might just have us call the field in sight at some point and let us do the visual that way. Ten thousand feet, 30 miles is a good reference, and we're pretty much there. 10,000 feet, about 31 miles, so that's about where I wanted to be on the descent, so that all kind of worked out nice. We do 10,000 feet, 30 miles from the field. 4,000 for my trailing. So we'll start the descent down to 4,000. That's just usually what we do as a reference. Oh, I need to chop my speed here, actually, before I do that. Whoops. Breaking the law. I need to be 250 below 10. So let me go ahead and fix that real quick. Breaking the law.
Airport site, Southwest 345. Southwest 345, clear visual approach, runway 14 right.
Let's go ahead and get below the 250. There we go. Now we'll start our descent down to 4,000. Do our best to maintain 250 knots. Very good. Nobody saw that, by the way, chat. If the feds ask, we were 250 below 10.
4 Mike Charlie, turn 10, 10 degrees right, vectors to mile.
10 right, 4 Mike Charlie. So heading 4 right. It's a vector to final, so we'll go ahead and go green world since he's already given us the vectors here. And I'll go ahead and do the activate vectors to final.
Zero, turn left, heading 170.
Boom. Just like that. She's all set and ready to go for the approach. I haven't been in this sim, and I haven't been in this airplane in the sim in quite some time, so I'm curious to see what my landing is going to be like. I got that coming up pretty soon. Get your landing rate guesses ready to go. Don't put them in yet. Don't put them in yet. Wait till we get a little bit closer before we put those in, but get them ready in your mind for what you want.
Contact.
I zoom in with the downwind sim binoculars, I can just barely make out the field through the haze right here, chat. A little bit of cheating with the other aircraft down there, I won't lie, but it's out there. And if he asks, we will call the field in sight. This controller, of course, is quieter than the others, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn him up. We're getting pretty close here, so I'm going to start bringing my speed back. We don't want to come in too hot, then we won't be able to slow down for the approach. So I'm going to let the throttle be at idle and start to slow down as we get closer here within 10 miles. 180 for the flaps.
Turn right, heading 250.
I think we got like 200 for the gear. I don't remember the exact gear speed, but it's 180 for the first notch flaps. I do remember that.
Cessna 060, descend to maintain 2,400.
5,000 for 4,000.
United 674, Omaha departure radar contact, climb and maintain 15,000. Turn left heading 030.
15,000, field in sight for Phenom 4 Mike Charlie when it helps.
Phenom 4 Mike Charlie, enter a left base, clear visual for retro line 18.
Clear visual 18, Phenom 4 Mike Charlie. Left base, so I'll turn to a heading here to kind of square it off, chat.
Southwest 345.
So help us to get slowed down and get to an appropriate altitude. I've got the frequency set for the approach. Is it not working? Hello? 110.1 or 111.1 set. 111.1. Okay, so hopefully it'll. There it is. IOCZ. IOCZ, alright, there we
go. Present heading, maintain 2,400 till established.
So let's go ahead and go, this is looking good right there. Level off, we'll start to slow down. Go all the way down to speed 150 here soon. A little bit closer here and I'll make my turn towards the final. Tell you what, I'm for speed 170 for the time being. That'll give me enough to get the flaps in here in just a second. Again, we do have the airport is off our left here. We're just squaring it off. Flaps one, that'll help maintain our speed. We'll go for 170. And we'll start our turn here in just a minute. And let's make it happen. Hit the approach button since we are clear for the approach. Let the airplane kind of guide us in for the visual here. Localizer's alive. It's taking it.
Cessna 060, contact Omaha Tower 132.1.
We'll go ahead and put the gear down.
United 674, contact Minneapolis.
And we'll go flaps 3. That'll get us fully configured. We'll slow to our approach speed. You can get your landing rate guesses in the chat. Now is the time. Landing rate guesses chat, because we are coming up on the final approach fix. What do you think my landing rate is going to be? It has been a long time since I've flown this airplane.
Phenom 4 Mike Charlie, wind 180 at 14, runway 18, clear to land.
18, clear to land. Phenom 4 Mike Charlie.
Come fly with me.
Big Cal 15, thank you for the follow. I appreciate it. Thanks for coming in today. Go ahead and put your prediction in for my landing rate as we're just joining the final here for the ILS into Lincoln, Nebraska. The visual, runway 18, backed up by the ILS. We're letting the plane do most of the work for us. I won't lie, chat. But I will click off the autopilot here in just a second. And by just a second, I mean right now. The autopilot's gone. The scary pilot, which is me, I'm the scary pilot, chat, and I'm on. There's our outer marker.
King 3-1, Omaha departure. Radar contact.
Gear down, flaps 3, which is our approach flaps 4 right now. We have flaps 2. Let's go flaps 3. That'll actually be our approach flaps, chat. There we go. Now we're fully configured and we are clear to land.
Number 325 Romeo. Yeah,
Zach Arctic, thanks for coming in today. Good to see you in the chat. I gotta remember that this plane loves to float in the sand, loves to float. So I'm gonna try my best to not float 75,000 feet down the runway. Speed brakes. Oh, that's right, you can't arm the speed brakes. That's fine. But,
King 3-1, I copied the ILS 18. Didn't get your second request. You're coming in a bit broken.
Roger, after the ILS runway 18, we'd like the RNAV runway 14R8, and then that second one to be a full stop.
King 3-1, Roger, you can expect that.
Pretty easy approach, not too much wind in Lincoln tonight. Right down the pike, too. 18810 was the last I checked the wind. That makes things pretty easy.
4500, and we're over Fremont requesting flight following to Lincoln, please.
Aircraft calling for flight following. Say again, call sign only, please.
Call sign is Pilot Club 6.
Pilot Club 6, squawk 4544.
Pilot Club 6.
4544, Pilot Club 6.
That's definitely something I'm not interested in doing, Chad, is having an actual call sign for the virtue of Safe Flying Club. No interest. We're going to do it the old-fashioned way, keeping our end registrations when we do our GH flying. Coming up on our final approach here. I'm going to dip a little below here because, again, this plane loves to float.
Position as reported, altitude in case 4,500.
Granted, we do have 12,000 feet of runway.
Okay, Roger, pilot club 6.
I can really milk this if I want to, but I'm going to ignore that glide slope because, again, we're visual.
Left 270, descend to maintain 3,000.
Left 270 to 3,000. King 3-1.
Go ahead and chop the power out here. Again, not too much flare because this thing loves to float. And oh yeah, 157, that's a great landing. Take that all day. We don't even need to go that hard on the brakes because this is a long runway.
United 478.
Some safe taxi up here so I can actually see where I'm going. I don't even remember where the FBO is on this field. I think it's off to the left.
Omaha, no idea.
See, go on to AirNav real quick and see if I can't get it before I need to exit. Where is the FBO? Yeah, they're both off to the left, so we'll exit left. We'll go to, looks like Ross is the north and Duncan is the south FBO. We'll go to Ross. And Phenom 4 Mike Charlie is clear of runway 18 on Kilo, taxi to Ross.
Say again, you're parking for Mike Charlie?
Ross Aviation.
For Mike Charlie, I'm unfamiliar with Lincoln. I presume it's a left turn off the runway.
Yep, so it'll be over on the... that would be the east ramp there, off of Alpha and Kilo.
Number 4, Mike Charlie, roger, thanks. Tag to the parking via Delta, Kilo, and Alpha if you need it, cross runway 32.
Alright, Kilo cross 32, and do you want us to hold short of 17?
That is the runway there, affirmative.
Alright, cross 32 short of 17 on Kilo, if you don't want 24, Mike Charlie.
Departure Mountain 5826 at Lincoln, clearance to North Platte.
Mountain 5826 on request.
So clear across the first, we'll hold short of the second.
3-1, turn left.
Take a look at those landing rates in a second. 157 was the official number there, chat. Let's remember 157 so that in case I forget. So clear left, clear right. Oh my god.
King 3-1, that was completely unreadable and just some awful annoyance.
King 3-1, left turn heading on side.
Jesus, that guy's got some
King
issues.
King 3-1, you're still coming in completely unreadable.
Whatever's going on with his mic. Ross Aviation's pretty much going to be right off of taxiway Kilo, looks like. Or just to the left of taxiway Kilo. So left. So probably like this hangar right here. Like where these aircraft are parked over there to the left, that's Ross Aviation. So we'll hold short of this runway and then we'll cross and make the left on Alpha.
7-0-0-6-0, Omaha departure, radar contact, altitude indicates 2000. Maintain VFR, proceed on course.
For my Charlie short of 17.
Chasing Giant 17, 71 Heavy, passing 47-100.
Giant 71 Heavy, Omaha departure, radar contact, climb and maintain 15,000.
Climb and maintain 15,000, and also we are on a 150. Sorry, 180.
Phenom 4 my Charlie short of 17.
Rip, keep that heading for just a few more miles.
Oh, I stepped on him again.
Roger that, my heading.
Whoops-a-daisy.
Approach Cessna 060, we'll go ahead and catch the flight following.
Cessna 060, roger. Radar service terminated, frequency change approved. Squawk VFR, have a good night.
VFR, frequency change approved, we'll see you. Cessna 060.
Giant 71 Heavy, turn right, heading 0, correction 250.
We'll wait. Short of 17 for 4 Mike Charlie.
King 3-1, contact Omaha Tower 132.1.
King 3-1, radio check.
King 3-1, you're loud and clear. And you can contact Tower 132.1, I'm talking about.
Our way, contact Tower King.
I just realized Delilah's sleeping on the floor of the chat behind me. Didn't
and
realize that.
Omaha departure, Los Altos 22D6 passing 3,300 for 5.
Southwest 2286, Omaha departure, radar contact, climb and maintain 15,000.
FBO 15,000, 2286.
United 478, I switched you a while ago, contact Minneapolis Center, actually now it's 125.3.
Alright, 25 minutes, 478, no, we never heard you call.
Giant 71 Heavy, turn right, heading 250.
due to the
Mountain 5826, I have your clearance, advisory copy.
5826, ready.
Mountain 5826, cleared to the North Platte Airport as filed.
He forgot about his chat. It's okay, we'll set the parking brake. Let's go look and see who won the landing rate contest.
Partners with me, Squawk. 173, 213,
120, 99, 200. Looks like Kenny Monster wins it.
North Platte Airport as filed, climbing tank 5,000, expect 16,000.
173 is close to 157. Congratulations there, Kenny Monster. Well done.
Mountain 5826, read that correct. Break 4 Mike Charlie, clear to cross 17.
Cross 17, 4 Mike Charlie, thank you. Release parking brake, clear to cross, clear left, clear right. I'm gonna make the left turn on Alpha to Ross. Your standard 173 worked for you tonight, Kenny, because you were the closest to the 157.
2286. Climb and maintain 14,000.
After 14,000,
2286. Make the next right turn into the ramp for Ross Aviation. We'll shut her down.
Lincoln Airport sets your 12 o'clock and about 10 miles, port side. Sierra
Papa, you can make a straight in, runway 18. Load up talent at Minneapolis, go down. Sounds good, man. I'm sure Approach will love to have the traffic from you.
South of 2286, turn left, correction right, heading 210.
Go ahead and clear to our right here, and we'll turn into the ramp.
November 17, November, Sierra. I'm sorry if you were calling. I did not hear you. Try again.
And we'll just park her up right here. Anywhere I'll do. We'll go get some princess parking. How about that? We'll go right to the door over here. Get some princess parking. Dear Lord.
Ow.
We're going to go ahead and disconnect from the network because I'm tired of that. So we're no longer on VATSIM chat. Couldn't handle that anymore. Anywhere will do. This is good enough. We'll set the parking brake. Before I turn everything off, let's go ahead, since we are disconnected. There's replays in Flight Sim 20, or X-Plane 11. This is not Flight Sim 2020, it's X-Plane 11. So let's go replay mode. And we're going to do a little replay action on the landing here. How far back do we need to go? See how the landing looks from outside. Oh yeah. I don't know about you, chap. That's about as good as it's gonna get. Let's see what it looked like from our passenger's perspective here. I don't know why the spoilers deploy early in the replay compared to what they would have done in the actual sim, because that wouldn't have happened until I landed, but in the replay it shows them up. But you get the idea. Oh yeah. I can live with that, chat. I can live with that. Let's go ahead and shut it down. So parking brake is set. We'll go ahead and stop. And do doom, just turn everything off, flip a bunch of switches, who cares, it's fine, we'll open the door, we'll open the forward pegs, we'll open the aft bag, put the static elements on. We're done. We have completed our journey for the evening, chat. Ah, it's such a beautiful plane here in X-Plane 11. Oh, I enjoyed flying it tonight. I hope you guys enjoyed watching it too. That's gonna do it for me. Let me see if I can find someone who's streaming so we can raid someone. That's what we like to do on this channel. I don't know. Am I feeling a random raid or am I feeling, let's see, what are we feeling? I think I'm feeling a random raid tonight, chat, so bear with me as I try and find someone who's streaming some Microsoft Flight Simulator that we can randomly raid. What is this? Let's find someone to randomly raid. Someone that's maybe doing some GA. No, I don't want videos, chat. I want... What are you... Twitch. What are we doing, Twitch? There we go. Live channels. Thank you. Good lord. Talking... I know you see playing. I'm talking to myself off the screen, chat. We're going to find someone random doing some GA to raid on Twitch. Bear with me here. Let's find some GA, preferably in English. Some bias flying GA, but that was definitely not English that I read on those titles, chat. Bush flying, Okando. Let's see what this guy's doing. Yeah, he's doing some bush flying, all right. He's got a sick mustache, chat. Let's go raid him. Whoever this Okando is, we're going to raid him. So thank you for coming in today. I hope you guys have a great night. Stay safe. SJFly2, thank you for lurking. I appreciate it. I'm glad you enjoyed the stream. So we'll do the random raid of this guy. Thanks for coming in today, everybody. Have a great night. Stay safe.